Hello everyone, welcome to a new tutorial in this series of basic electrical and electronics engineering. And in this tutorial we'll talk about a very basic network element, a capacitor. So in this tutorial I'll try to discuss all the aspects of a capacitor, how is it capable of storing energy and how does this energy discharges. So a capacitor is the second most popular passive network element, which is used after a resistor, and the basic function of a capacitor is to store electrical energy in the form of the electric field. Now let us understand what is a capacitor. A capacitor is nothing but it consists of two parallel plates sandwiched with a dielectric material. So this is the basic construction of a capacitor, having two metal plates and having a dielectric material. And the symbol that we commonly used for a capacitor is this. So let's understand how the charge is developed across the plates of this capacitor. Now this dielectric material which is present between the two plates of a capacitor is basically an insulator. So by its basic nature, this dielectric material being an insulator does not allow the flow of charge across it. So the moment we connect a battery of V volts across this capacitor, the charge starts to build up on the plates of the capacitor. Now this end, being negatively charged, will start providing electrons. Now these electrons will move towards this plate of the capacitor and will have the accumulation of negative charge on the lower plate of the capacitor, and similarly on the upper side will have a positive charge building up. Now because this portion will not allow the movement of charge, so this charge, due to the application of the voltage across the capacitor, starts building up on the plates of the capacitor, and this building of charge continues till the potential difference across the two plates becomes equal to the voltage that we have applied across the capacitor. So due to the building up of charge, here we have a resultant potential difference, and due to the presence of the potential difference, we have a net electric field which exists across this capacitor. And please remember that this mechanism of building up of charge on the plates of the capacitor is known as the charging of the capacitor. The charging of the capacitor. And this process of charging of the capacitor, or in other words the building up of charge, will continue till the point the potential difference so developed becomes equal to the applied voltage across the plates. And the resultant electric field given by E is mathematically expressed as V upon D. Now this is the electric field which develops here, and this V is the voltage which is applied, and D is the distance between the two plates of the capacitor. So I'll mark it here. D is the distance between the two plates of the capacitor. So you can see the dependence of the electric field, that it is directly proportional to the applied voltage and it is inversely proportional to the distance between the parallel plates of the capacitor. So more the distance, lesser is the resultant electric field, and vice versa. So this whole process which I have just discussed can be termed as the storage of energy. So this is how a capacitor starts storing energy in the form of electric field across the plates. Now, once this capacitor is fully charged, and let us say at that moment I remove this battery with the voltage V. Now, under this condition, when this battery of V volts is removed, the charge which has already built up still remains there, and this built up charge is only looking out for some conducting path across which it can flow. So to demonstrate this condition, I'll redraw this diagram. So let us assume that the capacitor is now fully charged like this, and we have a kind of switch here, and I remove this battery and I replace this with a load in the form of a bulb. Now, in this condition, this capacitor is fully charged due to the presence of the battery, and once this is removed and I close this switch, then from the bottom plate where we have the negative charge build up, these electrons are attracted towards the top plate which has positive charge. So because the opposite charges are going to attract each other, so this negative charge is attracted towards the positive charge on the opposite plate via this path the moment this switch is closed. So when these electrons start moving via this path when the switch is closed, they start, two things are going to happen. First, the bulb will immediately glow because it has a flow of current, and second, these electrons, the moment they reach here, would start combining with the positive charge which is present on the opposite side of the plate of the capacitor. And in other words, the charge which was built up would now start discharging, and this discharge mechanism can be observed with the glow of the bulb which is connected as a load here. And the moment this completely discharges, the bulb here will automatically be off and will know that the capacitor has completely discharged itself. So that is how the charging and discharging of capacitor takes place. And now, after having understood the charging and the discharging of the capacitor, let us understand what basically is capacitance of a capacitor. Now, by definition, capacitance is the ability of a capacitor to store charge. That is how the capacitance is defined. And mathematically, capacitance is the charge Q stored per unit volt applied across the capacitor plates. So capacitance is the charge stored per unit voltage. That is the mathematical expression, and the units that are used for the capacitance is farad. And this farad, practically being a bigger unit, we most of the times use millifarads or microfarads or even picofarads, but farad is the SI unit for the capacitance. And now let us see on what factors the capacitance of a capacitor depends. So factors affecting the capacitance can be understood with the help of this mathematical formula, where capacitance C is given by epsilon A upon D. So there we have another important formula related to capacitance C. Now here A is the area of cross section. Of the plates of the capacitor, and D is the distance between the plates, and epsilon is the permittivity of dielectric material. And this permittivity of dielectric material epsilon is mathematically given by epsilon naught into epsilon r. Now let us see how the capacitance is depending on these factors. Now the first factor is the area of cross section of plates. So this area of cross section of plates, the capacitance changes directly with the change in the area of cross section, and it is inversely proportional to the distance d between the parallel plates of the capacitor. And talking about the permittivity of dielectric material, now here epsilon r is the relative permittivity, or in other words it is also known as the dielectric constant of the material. Now in order to understand the permittivity, please understand that the dielectric material that we have here between the two parallel plates of the capacitor is basically an insulating material. That's point number one. And number two is that it has polar molecules. So when it has polar molecules, these molecules are something like this, having polarity in the molecules. Now when there is no voltage applied across a capacitor, then the molecules of this dielectric material are randomly aligned. So the net electric field due to the random alignment of these molecules is zero or nil. But the moment we apply the voltage across a capacitor, now if we understand the alignment of these polar molecules of the dielectric material, there are two conditions. Condition number one is when no voltage is applied. Now when no voltage is applied across a capacitor, then the dielectric material has its molecules randomly aligned. But under this scenario, when the voltage is applied across the capacitor, then in that case, let us say that the positive charge is developed on the upper plate of the capacitor and the negative charge is developed on the lower plate of the capacitor, as we have seen here in this case, then the alignment of the molecules is such that the negative polarity is aligned towards the positively charged plate of the capacitor and the positive polarity is aligned towards the negatively charged plate of the capacitor. Now please understand that due to a regular non-random alignment of the molecules of this dielectric material, it tends to develop its own electric field inside the plates of the capacitor. And this development of electric field due to the alignment of these molecules is such that it opposes the electric field which is developed on the plates of the capacitor. Now, due to this opposition, the effective electric field which we are talking about tends to reduce. Now, this is a very important point here, that due to the alignment, this effective electric field tends to reduce, And when this effective electric field tends to reduce, it as a consequence reduces the potential difference, which is the result of the development of charge across the plates of the capacitor. And now, to increase this potential difference, the capacitor tends to store more amount of the charge across its parallel plates. And so the end result is the more storage of charge across the parallel plates of the capacitor due to this factor epsilon, which is the permittivity of dielectric material. So I hope you understand, because the dependence of capacitance C on the area of cross section and D is a matter of its fabrication, how the distance between the plates is maintained, or how are we keeping the area of cross section of the plates. But to understand the dependence of the capacitance on this factor epsilon is very important, which I hope you've understood. So the capacitor can store more amount of charge due to the reduced electric field as a result of this alignment of the molecules of the dielectric material that is placed inside the plates of the capacitor. So that is all about the capacitor, and I hope you understand the charging, the discharging, and the factors which are affecting the value of the capacitance for a particular capacitor. So I'll see you soon with more such videos, and till then keep visiting the channel and keep sharing the videos. Have a good day. Bye.